Welcome to Piscataway, Jersey Mike's Arena, known as the Rack, home to the Rutgers Scarlet Knights, who tonight on the Big Ten Network welcome the Penn State Nittany Lions as both teams are looking for their first conference win of the season. And joining us today, the former Buckeye superstar, four-time and all-Big Tenner, always with a bright big smile, it is my pleasure to have Lexi Mattern in the hot seat tonight on the Big Ten Network. And hello, everybody. I am Dean Linke with Lexi Mattern. And Lexi, welcome to the Big Ten Network. Great to have you here.
Thank you. I'm super excited to be here tonight, transitioning from the competition floor into the studio tonight. I'm excited to be here for the opportunity.
Well, and you know, we got two teams that are looking to make a little more noise this year in Penn State and Rutgers. We'll start with Penn State. Who do you have your eye on?
Tonight, I have my eye on Avra Petrahita of the Nittany Lions. She is an integral part of this Nittany Lion team. She's competed in the all-around every meet of her career. That's incredibly difficult to do. Coach Brown said it's her best gymnastics that she's putting out on the floor tonight. Next, we're going to take a look at Kayla McGillicutt. She is just a freshman and a Big Ten freshman to watch at that. She's incredibly dynamic on the beam. She's looking for clean lines and a stuck dismount, and she has quite the difficulty on this event, and it would be quite incredible if she could win the beam tonight. Lastly, we're going to take a look at Isabella Salcedo. She is quite a sassy gymnast, and she brings her personality to everything that she does. Her floor routine has a lot of difficulty in dynamic tumbling, and she is going to bring the heat on this event.
Rutgers also has quite a bit of personality, Lexi.
Absolutely. Aaliyah Aird is one of the gymnasts to watch for this team. She's going to compete in the all-around tonight, and her execution and her personality is what makes her such a strong floor competitor. But we're going to get a chance to see her on every event tonight, looking to capitalize on the all-around tonight. Emily Leese for the Scarlet Knights is a senior and a Big Ten gymnast to watch. She has a huge Yurchenko 1.5. That's a 10-0 start. It's incredibly difficult to do, but she shines on the beam as well. High level of difficulty and execution to detail is what coach wants to see from her tonight. Avery Bowser, another incredible athlete. We're only going to get to see her on the bars tonight, but she does it so well. We're going to look for clean, concise handstands, pointed toes. The judges aren't going to have a lot to put pen to paper to, hopefully, for her tonight, and we're looking to see her come out with a big bar win.
Great job setting the table, Lexi, as Umi Salim Beasley, now in her sixth season as the Rutgers head coach. She was a superstar at West Virginia, like fellow Big Ten coach Bev Plotke. She actually had a 10 on the bars during her time at West Virginia, has a deep team, and that is the vault lineup for Umi Salim Beasley. Obviously, we enjoyed our time with her yesterday. And for Penn State, Sarah Brown. She's like, I am who I am. I talk fast, I'm loud, and I'm proud. And she's really settling into being who she is.
Absolutely. She took over this Nittany Lion team quite a few years ago, had to rebrand, and she's setting not only a name for herself, but this Team 60. 60 years of Penn State gymnastics, which she wants to celebrate. And I think those new leotards do it well with the Nittany Lion heads all over them.
Yeah, excellent point. Just the other day, we celebrated 50 years of Minnesota gymnastics, and Sarah's like, hang on, we're 10 years older at Penn State. And looking to bring some heat this year is Sarah Brown and the Penn State Nittany Lions. As always, Penn State is loaded. There's eight teams in the top 25, Lexi. I'll tell you what, they're going to be adding UCLA and Washington as well. The Big Ten's going to get even better.
It's such a great place for the Big Ten to be in. There's already a lot of competition within the Big Ten. Then they're going to add very competitive teams with UCLA and Washington. They bring a high level of difficulty and execution. And UCLA has housed a lot of former Olympians as well. So this brings such a high level of competition to all sports in the Big Ten.
And speaking of those eight teams in the top 25, that'll be the focus of our State Farm State of Success. You can check it out at roadtonationals.com. Michigan at 10, your Buckeyes right there at 11. Obviously, Rutgers and Penn State would like to find their way in to the top 25. just getting ready, where, of course, Rutgers will start on the vault. Penn State will start on the bars. And any way you slice it, I feel like both coaches in their own way, Lexi, said they want to win without flat out saying they want to win. But, you know, they always do that progress thing. We're making progress. But I felt like they kind of leaked in there. We need a victory here.
Of course, it's super important to focus on the wins if you're the coaching staff. You can say those things or maybe even think it to yourself. But what both coaches stressed to us when we spoke to them earlier this week is that they want to control what they are able to control and the tangible things for each one of their athletes, landings, body positions, the things that they've coached their athletes to do well in the gym. But of course, Penn State's on the road. Those scores mean a little bit more because it leads into your national qualifying score, but Rutgers is at home and has a chance to get comfortable with their home crowd on this Thursday night.
Nice Leos for Rutgers. They probably remind you a little bit of your Ohio State Leos, don't they?
Just a little bit. Makes me a little nostalgic, but I will not be putting on a leotard. Although, Dean, do you want to put one on?
No, thank you. Nobody wants to see that. I will tell you this, though.
I
am always wondering about right before that first event, the nerves are a little different, right?
It's the beginning of a very long evening in most cases, and the nerves are going, but a lot of the times you're just excited. And once you finally touch the vault or the bars for the first time, you're ready. Those nerves just calm down, and they're prepared to do this.
All right, here we go. As you see, three sophomores, two juniors, and a senior in the lineup for Umi Salim Beasley, who's got three talented daughters of her own. And we'll begin with Valentina Lorente Garcia, who is a sophomore from Virginia Beach, Virginia. And she comes in with a career high of 9.825. As we are off and rolling with Lexi Mattern here on the Big Ten Network.
Yurchenko full to open up this Scarlet Knight lineup. She did have her chest down a little bit on the landing. We'll take another look at it here. She had a great entry. Excellent block off the table, but it looks like her chest was just a little low with a small step forward.
So Penn State on the bars, they are right around that 40 mark nationally. They'll lead off with Jessica Johansson, who has a career high of 9.9 and a season high of 9.825, which she scored in her last meet. Jessica Johansson on the bars for the Nittany Lions.
Excellent handstands. Into a release move. It looks like she caught her foot on the high bar, and that will be a deduction. Back up to the high bar. She gears up for her dismount. Big double layout with a stuck landing. That was an excellent recovery after a slight mishap early in the routine. The coaches are going to be happy with her recovery. Look at that dismount. A little leg separation on that double layout, but again, a great recovery and a great landing for that routine. Not quite the leadoffs that either team was looking for, but good recovery nonetheless.
All right, that'll get a set for Maya Jones, the junior from McKinney, Texas, who has a career high of 9.85 on the vault. You see Valentina in with a 9.7 as the leadoff for the Scarlet Knights.
Another Yurchenko full, beautiful execution in the air, but she did have a rather large hop back in the landing. That'll be a bit of a deduction. Another look at it here. See her get right into that table with a huge block. Chest was nice and high, but couldn't quite find the landing. I bet her coaches are going to be happy with that call, though. Beautiful execution in the air. Wow. Wish she could have found that landing there at the end.
That second hop always seems to make a little bit of difference as well.
Yes.
So move back over to Maddie Johnston for Penn State. Career high 9.9, season high 9.825, which she had last week.
She has one of the most beautiful bar routines for the Nittany Lions. She has impeccable handstands, which we just saw there. Beautiful blindfolded double back, sticks the landing. Incredible bar routine for the Nittany Lions. That should score well.
I believe that will be higher than last week's score of 9.825. That was solid.
This was a very solid routine. Look at how her elevation in that double back went above the bar before she dropped perfectly out of the air and didn't move her feet one bit.
So Johansson and then Johnston, 1-2 for Sarah Brown right there, giving the high five as we move over to Rachel Riley, the sophomore from Canada. She's got a career high of 9.75 on the vault, and she is third to go for the Scarlet Knights.
Looking to get a cleaner landing than her teammates before her. Another Yurchenko full. It was a concise landing, still had a hop back, but again, executed very well in the air. Couldn't quite have those sticky feet that we want to see. Great entry. Looks like her legs were a little separated on top of the horse there, but plants those feet after the hop to minimize deductions.
Well said. Just one hop and then got her feet squared. We're still waiting on the score for Johnston as McGilligan. It's not that often a freshman comes in as a Big Ten to watch, but she's got a great pedigree and is going to be outstanding at Penn State.
She is one of the athletes to watch. Coach Brown said that this is one of the events that she shines on.
9.775, her best score in the short season.
Showing the difficulty with that release up to the high bar and then transitioning into a packed salto back to the low bar. Faltered a handstand into a double back dismount, sticks the landing and holds it. There's a new rule in the NCAA for gymnastics this year that requires the athletes to hold their landings for a strong second before they salute the judges, and that's exactly what Kayla did here. Her feet are planted, she held it, and then she saluted the judges. Excellent height on the dismount. Finishes with a smile. It's an impressive routine for a freshman.
Yeah, bright future. As now we move to the only all-arounder for Rutgers that you did such a great job spotlighting, Aaliyah Aird. Aaliyah Aird, a junior from Garden, Florida, Windermere High School. Career high, 9.875.
Another Yurchenko full for the Scarlet Knights. She did take a small step back on her landing, but she looked much more in control of her vault. Had nice tight glued legs in the air. Take another look here. Excellent block off the table and elevation. Good distance from the table as well. Just a small step back. That should be a great score for the Scarlet Knights.
Gabby Galantine will be next to go for Penn State. She has a career high of 9.95, her season high. She set in the last meet of a 9.75. Anytime you've got a 9.95 as a career high, you're pretty good.
Pretty good. It's pretty close to perfect. Beautiful handstands. Keeps her legs together on the backswing into that back salto. Beautiful cast handstand. She holds it there for a second. Wow, what an incredible double layout to end that routine to a stuck landing. You know what they say, Dean, sticks are contagious. So hopefully they can continue those sticks. Another look at this dismount. Legs glued perfectly together, toes are pointed. You might have been able to walk underneath that, Dean.
The transfer from Florida by way of Iron Station, North Carolina, Gabby Galantine. Nice performance. Big hug from Sarah Brown.
Saw her get really excited there after that routine.
Yeah, solid. There's Gabrielle Dildy, the freshman from Virginia Beach, Virginia, as Rutgers has had back-to-back 9.775s.
Shevchenko, full small hop back. That might have been the best vault we've seen all evening. Beautiful execution in the air. Let's take another look. Big block off the table. Legs are glued together. Finds the ground. Just a small hop back. You can see the confidence on her face there, Dean.
Yeah, big smile at home. Called the Rack Jersey Mike's Arena.
I love seeing the confidence on the athletes' faces after a job well done.
Ava Piedrahita. She really lights up the Big Ten Network screen. She did all last year in her rookie campaign. Good to see her again. The sophomore from Maryland went to Damascus. And here comes one of the superstars, I think, of the Big Ten.
It's so hard to do the all-around every week. And for her to do it every meet of her career, it's just incredible. It's a great bar routine so far. Right up to that handstand. Fooling dismount, sticks the landing. That bar routine was executed so well, and that's what coach said that is expected from her every routine that she does. Beautiful pack salto. Cast right up to that handstand pirouettes on top of the bar. And right up to that second handstand, those are the details that the judges want to see you hit time after time. It's what separates you from a good bar routine to a great bar routine, the stuck landings and the hit handstands.
A lot of elegance, career high 9-9. See if she can chase that down. Now the anchor for Rutgers, Emily Lease, who you also put the spotlight on in the open. They need a big score here.
I've been waiting for this ball. Yurchenko, 1.5. Just a small hop back at the last second. I spoke too soon. This vault is incredibly difficult to do because it is a blind landing. Another look here.
Great she had the stick.
She had it there. Just a, looks like she was a little back on her heels. Look at how quick she gets into the table, opens her arms up. It's so well done that I wanted her to stick.
Senior from Lancaster, PA. Cassidy Rushlow, elected to come back for what we're calling the super senior slash COVID year. Cassidy Rushlow with a 9.975 career high. Her last meet, she had a 9.8. Cassidy Rushlow.
I love watching her lines on this event. I don't know very many other athletes that do it better than she does. Look at this huge Jaeger.
Oh. Ooh.
Unfortunately misses her hands on that release.
Well, she gets reset. We can tell you Lease with a 9-9 as we take a look here at the fall.
She's super high above the bar and just didn't hold on long enough to bring herself back to the bar in that rotation. She's just finger-tipped onto that bar and unfortunately falls. This is where the athlete's gonna have to go back to the chalk bucket and unfortunately restart their mental prep, but she's gonna have to pick up in the middle of her bar routine, which can be incredibly difficult to do. This will be a true testament of her training.
Ralph Brasso there, Michigan in his third season, assisting Sarah Brown.
Seems a little shaky, but recovers well in that past handstand. She's going to gear up for her dismount, looking to save every 10th here. Big full in. Just a small hop back on that landing. Another look at this dismount. Well above the bar. Huge height. Almost sticks it there. Looks like her feet are just a little too close together. It's easy for an athlete to get a little flustered when you have a fall, but she recovered well in that dismount.
Rutgers, this is an exhibition. Isabella Hughes with a career high of 9.825. This score will not count toward their team score, but a good opportunity for Isabella to show Umi Celine Beasley she belongs.
Tucked Yurchenko full. Great distance from the table, has a small hop back. Let's take another look. Good block off the table. Actually, looks like she was a little close to the table there. The judges look at two things, your height off the table and your distance from the table. You got to find that sweet spot there. But nonetheless, these exhibition routines are incredibly important.
So here's Maggie Mace. She'll be doing exhibition on the bars for the Penn State Nittany Lions. Maggie Mace is a senior from Trenton, Michigan, part of the Ohio Connections Academy in Cincinnati Gymnastics. She has a career high on the bars of 9.775. That's a pretty good score. Still trying to figure out Cassie Rushlow's score, which will, of course, be the score they drop, as there's six up, five count.
These judges' conferences can rattle athletes, but it looks like that one was over pretty quickly. She's going to want to use this routine as a practice run in front of the lights.
So they will drop Cassie Rushlow's score of 8.55.
Beautiful Maloney up to the high bar, a little pack salto. Did have a slight leg separation. Beautiful last cast handstand. And her double layout dismount. Slight pike down on the landing, but overall a great exhibition routine for the Nittany Lions. Should we get you a pair of Nittany Lion ears, Dean?
Yes, please. Thank you. As you see, Rutgers with a 49.025. They lead through the first rotation. Umi Salim Beasley, as she always does, getting ready to take off her shoes for the next rotation, as Rutgers will head to the bars and Penn State will head to the vault. Big huddle with all of the coaches there for the Penn State Nittany Lions. Through one rotation, Rutgers has the lead. Penn State, led by their superstar Ava Piedrahita, who had a 9-9 for the Nittany Lions. Always great to be in Piscataway. Nice crowd here at the rack. Take a look at the scores through the first rotation. Rutgers will head over to the bars. We'll take a look at their scores on the vault as Penn State warming up on the vault for the second rotation. So they dropped their lead off, and Emily Leese needed a big score. She delivered a big score.
She got the 9-9 that she deserves. That small hop back was the 10th that the judges took, because the execution in the air was textbook and as good as it comes. Job well done to Emily and this Rutgers vault lineup.
Dildy with a 9.85 and Rutgers with a 49.025. Cassidy Rushlow unfortunately fell. Ava, though, with the big 9-9. So Ava and Emily, 9-9s for their respective teams.
9-9s are great scores because they're pretty darn close to perfect. And these lineups did exactly what they were supposed to do. They built. Their leadoff was solid, and the scores and the routines built in difficulty and execution as they went on. So a job well done for Ava Piedrahita, and then the unfortunate fall for Cassidy Rushlow. That would have been another big score for the Nittany Lions.
So Ava will serve as the anchor again. Barova will be the leadoff for Sarah Brown. That's the lineup for the Nittany Lions on the vault.
This is a good mix of athletes ranging in their experience, competition experience. While they've done gymnastics for years, there's nothing quite like putting on your university leotard and competing for your teammates.
Take a look at Umi Salim Beasley's lineup, as she'll slide in a freshman right in the middle, and then Avery Balzer. This is her event, and I know you're expecting a big score from Balzer as the anchor for Rutgers.
I am. But again, we talk to these coaches, and while the scores aren't something that they can control, the gymnastics is what they can control. They're looking for clean lines, just like that cast handstand we saw, although this is still warm-ups. But handstands and legs glued together, stuck dismounts, holding it for just that second before they salute the judges, those are going to be the key things that we're looking for to not allow the judges to put pen to paper.
Real quick, Lexi, on your first rotation, let's say you had a big score. Talk about how you were feeling headed into the second rotation if you had a big score in rotation number one.
If I am the coaches, I would be feeling pretty good. I think the coaches look more at the scores. But as the coach, I'm telling my athletes not to look at the scores. To feel good about their performances means more than what the scores are showing. They want their athletes to go based off of a good vibe, feel good, and trust your training. We're looking at Coach Umi Salim Beasley there, telling her athletes with a smile how she expects them to do their routines. And I take a guess that she's telling them to trust their training, that they've trained well all week. They've had a strong preseason, a hard preseason nonetheless, but they're expected to put their best foot forward and control what they can control. I think the girls are feeling good after their first rotation, and those little jitters of pre-meet have probably come and gone, and they're probably feeling very settled into this arena.
So here we go with the Penn State Nittany Lions as Alina Varroa, 9.875 career high.
Beautiful front handspring, front pike, just a small hop forward. A quick note on landings that are forward facing, you're going to want to see them go forward and not backward. So she has an excellent block off the table, nice closed tight pike, and just the tiniest hop forward, chest is elevated. Excellent leadoff for the Nittany Lions.
That's the junior from Latvia. Tina Lorente Garcia with a career high of 9.7, the leadoff for the Scarlet Knights on the bars.
Nice deep breath before she starts. Great release up to the high bar. Covers well off, she's a little close. Gearing up for her dismount. Great double layout. She's super excited. Sticks the landing. This was a wonderful leadoff for the Scarlet Knights. Great opportunity to capitalize and move forward. We're going to take another look here at her dismount. Slight leg separation. Her legs are a little loose. But when it goes so quick, we're not really sure what the judges see. But overall, an excellent leadoff, hit her handstands.
Here's Amani Herring with a career high of 9.8, season high of 9.75. Her last meet, she had a 9.675, a sophomore from Denville, New Jersey.
Yurchenko full. Excellent distance from the table, just a small hop back. These Yurchenko fools have a start value of a 9.95. Another look here. Look at that block off the table. Clean twist. Just a hop back.
Penn State, Sarah Brown, her four pillars, passion, grit, trust, and commitment. It's kind of their mantra they stand by. Rutgers Scarlet Knights now as Jacqueline Manifold ready to go. She's got a career high, Lexi, of a 9.7.
Huge release straight into the overshoot. Lots of air time in that release. Beautiful cross handstand. Very unique dismount as she actually goes forward into a 1.5 twist. Coach Beasley told us that we were going to see a lot of difficulty and unique routines from her team today, and this is one of them. Look at that dismount. That one and a half twist just takes a hop forward. But that was a beautifully executed routine going into the dismount. Keeps you on your toes.
Yeah, you're right. You don't see that dismount every day. Indeed. Maddie Johnston, career high 9.875, season high 9.825.
Your chick a full to a stuck landing. That is incredible. She had wonderful height in the air. I'm impressed. We talked about those contagious sticks. Let's see if they can keep it up. Another look at this vault. Great entry. Very clean block off the table. Finds the landing. And just salutes.
This will be a good score.
Should be a huge score for the Nittany Lions. Again, these Yurchenko Fools have the highest score that they can get is a 9.95. So while we won't see the 10, we're hoping to see those 9.95s.
Last meet was a 9.75. We'll see if she can top that.
I would say so. If I was the judge, I mean, I'm not. And maybe it's best that I'm here with you, Dean, and not at the judging table. But
good look at Olivia DeNovi, who is up next, the freshman from Mount Royal, New Jersey. 9.8 career high. Oh. So now both teams with a fall on the bars.
It's an uncharacteristic fall for an athlete at this stage. You see her pack salto, and it looks like she just didn't have her hands wrapped firmly around the bar. Those falls are tough on athletes. Will take her a second to rechalk and regroup. They have about 30 seconds before they're able to get back up on the bars. You can take as much or as little of that 30 seconds as you see fit.
May have got the wind knocked out of her a little bit there.
It definitely looked like it. Those mats do protect you, but landing like that on your back is always tough on your body. So recovery will be important. Excellent cast handstand. Just the dismount left. Blind full double back. All of the tenths count, all of your movements count after a fall. It's important that you try to keep it together the best you can for your team. You never know when those unfortunate mishaps may be a score that your team still has to count early on in the lineup. So while it's not the performance that they wanted, they have an opportunity to pick back up and keep going.
Here's Isabella Salcedo, so fun to watch. Career high 9.875, had a 9.7 in the last meet.
She has another unique vault. She does a Yurchenko entry, but a half turn onto the table, and then finishes with a front pike. Take another look at it here. You see this quick half turn onto the table. Huge block, very closed in her pike position. And just the tiniest hop. The judges may want to see a little bit more trajectory off the table and have her go a little bit farther out. She landed a little close to the table, but overall her execution was done very well.
Here's the all-arounder, Aaliyah Aird, career high on the bars, and 9.875 for the junior from Garden, Florida.
I've been excited to watch her on this event. She's an incredibly hard bar worker. Huge pike release. Straight into her overshoot to handstand. Just the dismount. Double layout. Small hop forward. Just a little bit of a pike down on that dismount, but a very clean routine for the Scarlet Knights.
After the fall from DeNovi, solid from Aird.
We talk about how hard it is to recover from a fall, but it's also incredibly difficult for the athlete that follows the fall. A lot of pressure is inherently put on you to pick back up and to get the momentum and the ball rolling for the team moving forward.
So here's Kalia McElligott.
Yurchenko full, stuck landing. She had a slight heel raise, but planted them right back down. Looks like her toes didn't move though, Dean, so I'd call it a stick. I'd be happy with that if I was Coach Brown. Another look at this. Very clean entry. Keeps the chest elevated. Oh, it looks like her toes did move just a hair. But a confident smile at the end of that ball.
She reminds me a little bit of the former Minnesota great Ona Loper. Long, lean.
Yes, very clean lines. Beautiful gymnast to watch.
So here's Myra Daniels, who comes in with a career high, Lexi, of a 9.725. She's a junior from Morristown, New Jersey, Morristown High School.
Flying full and an overshoot right to handstand. Beautiful Takachev. You don't see a lot of releases that come at the end of bar teams. It's incredibly difficult. Double layout, small hop back. Another unique bar routine with a high level of difficulty. Again, that Takachev will take another look here. Beautifully done, turns over, grabs the bar, and then has to go straight into her dismount. Double layout, flips above the bar, slight leg separation. Controls it after that hop. Job well done. This bar lineup is picking up nicely after that fall.
So here we go with Piedrahita as Ava Piedrahita, the anchor.
Wow. Another half on pike front off. They're doing these balls so well. They look clean. And she had a good landing. I'd be happy with that vault lineup.
So Ava Piedrahita, the anchor. Take a look at.
Excellent block off the table. She had very nice trajectory, good distance from the table. I'm impressed.
So Avery Balzer with a career high of 9.95. The anchor on the bars for Rutgers.
This is definitely a routine to watch. Line change into a massive straddle Jaeger. Holds that handstand, really showing it off. Double layout, just a hop forward on the landing. That might be the best bar team we've seen all evening, Dean.
Kind of what we were expecting.
It's exactly what I was expecting. Looks like she was expecting that from herself as well. Another look at this dismount. Legs are straight and extended. Finds the ground. Little bit of a hop. Just the hop forward. Again, we want to see the chest elevated and the heels planted into the ground to really go for that stick.
Exhibition, Cassidy Rushlow, the fifth year. This will not count for the team scores. Graduate student, part of Daggett Gold Medal Gymnastics.
She does a Yurchenko full and just is a little squatty in her landing. We're not quite sure if her knee hit the ground or not. If the knee does drop, then it is a fall. Another look here. Looks like she was a little past her block over top of the table. and just takes the step forward.
Rutgers will also bring out an exhibition as Mattis Raines, the freshman from Atlanta, Georgia.
Excellent straddled Jaeger to open up this bar routine. They're executing some very high-level gymnastics in these bar routines. And even the basics look strong as well. Double back dismount. It's a little weak in the knees there at the end, but a smile and a happy team. We're going to take another look at this huge straddled Jaeger. Her legs are perfectly straight. She flips well above the bar and right up into that cast handstand and holds it. So well done. Another look at that Stalder. Pushes right to handstand. Double back. Just wants to get more confident in that dismount.
I feel like we're going to see more of Raines. That was an exhibition, but she looks like she's got the chops to get her way into the lineup for the Rutgers Scarlet Knights. After two rotations, Penn State has taken a slim lead. They're at 98.075. Rutgers at 97.725. Hands all in for Umi Celine Beasley as Rutgers will move to the beam and Penn State will move to the floor. Both teams are ranked 40th overall. The Scarlet Knights, the Penn State Nittany Lions, both teams looking for their first Big Ten conference win. Women's gymnastics on the Big Ten Network is brought to you by State Farm. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. Eva Piedrahita with a big score, and then Lise with the top score on the vault for the Rutgers Scarlet Knights. We got a tight one here through two rotations. Alongside former Buckeye Lexi Mattern, I'm Dean Linke. You see 98.075. Rutgers at 97.725. Speaking of the Buckeyes, Monday, don't miss the top 25 women's gymnastics showdown when Ohio State, led by their head coach Meredith Paulusiewicz, competes against Illinois and Natalie Walsh. Coverage begins at 7 Eastern only on the Big Ten Network and the Fox Sports app. How the Buckeyes looking this season?
They look strong. They came ready to play, and they had some routines they had to fill. But they are filling them nicely, and their team looks strong and confident.
I heard they had a good matchup, tight matchup, with Olivia Karras' Michigan Wolverines. Take a look at the uneven results for Rutgers as we watch the Scarlet Knights warm up on beam. Anything stand out there?
That 9.85 from Avery Balser was such a beautiful routine to watch. I'd watch it on replay personally, Dean, but those 9.7s from Aaliyah Aird and Myra Daniels also were very clean routines, just a few little cleanups, but that means that the team on bars has room to grow and it's still early in the season.
Now Penn State, they get that 9.9 from Ava, the anchor for the Nittany Lions.
I'm not surprised by that 9.9. She had quite a excellent showing on vault. She had the height, the distance, and the landing. It was all there. And again, we're watching these scores rise as the lineup goes on. They drop the leadoff. That's what you want to see. And they're going to want to continue with that momentum through the rest of the meet.
That's season high, 49.225 for Penn State to give them the lead for Coach Brown and Penn State through two. Johnston, by the way, had a season high of 9.85, and Salcedo tied her career high of 9.875. I want to thank Grace Amberg and the great work she does on stats. Sarah Brown, a little chat with the judges.
Coach Brown actually is a judge herself, although she said she doesn't do it often because she'd rather be coaching and developing her athletes, but she knows what she's talking about.
Yeah, she was kind of funny as we got ready for this one, talking about understanding who she is. Here's the all-around through two events as Ava in the lead. with a 19.8. Got just 0.25 behind. Two all-arounders for Penn State. Aired the only all-arounder for Rutgers.
We mentioned earlier how difficult it is to compete the all-around. It's very tough on your body. Gymnastics is one of the few sports where you kind of have to be a jack of all trades and a master of really none. You have to just master your emotions and your training and your skill set, and it's incredibly difficult to do, especially at this level of gymnastics and in the Big Ten nonetheless, when the competition is very tight and it's only getting harder and the gymnastics is getting better.
Quick little huddle for Rutgers. Umi Celine Beasley is assisted by Anastasia Candia. We've seen Michael Rosso. And then also Danielle DeMarco. You probably recognized in some of the shots here on the Big Ten Network, Hannah Joyner, whose eligibility finally ran out, but she is still around as a student assistant coach. Hannah Joyner, one of the all-time greats.
One of the best athletes of her time out there on the competition floor, just transitioning into a new role. It's incredibly hard to hang up the leotard, but it's fun when you get to still hang out. Use your words of wisdom to help your team.
Working our way up to the third rotation, where we'll see Rutgers on the beam, Penn State on the floor. Jackie Manifold with a career high of 9-9, the leadoff for the junior from Albuquerque, New Mexico. Trained at Pecos Connections Academy, and here we go.
As we round this corner going into the second rotation, we're going to finally start to see the athletes' personalities come out on these next two events. Beautiful flight series, back handspring layout, step out. A mix of artistry and skill. Beautiful side aerial. It's kind of tough to see the beam as you flip over top of it. Leaps executed well. You want to see that 180 from toe to toe, getting a full split. Judges look for a few things in these beam routines, rhythm being one of them. They never want to see your body stop moving. Side aerial, 1.5, dismount. Wow, what a leadoff for the Scarlet Knights. Beam leadoffs are one of the hardest places to go in a lineup. You know that beam's smaller than your phone. 4 inches. 4 inches. And she did that beam routine like she was walking on the floor. Just
you
a small
said it.
Dismount.
Yep, good leadoff there for Manifold. Alyssa Kramer will get things started on the floor for Penn State. 9.875, her career season and last meet score. As Kramer, a freshman from State College, Pennsylvania, State High School, trained with Center Elite. Gotta believe it's a dream for her to be part of the Penn State team.
These are the moments as an athlete where you're ready to go, but something else is holding you up. You've done your mental prep. You're ready to start your routine. So you're just waiting. And it can be very hard to stay in your bubble.
Kramer.
Especially for a freshman.
Yeah. Kramer will perform to a Latin mix called Arriba.
We're expecting this floor lineup to be a party. In the words of their coach. That was a front double full to a punch front, and unfortunately she's very squatty in her knees. Looks like her butt did touch the ground. Are dancing along. Helps keep the energy nice and high, even when you're in an away meet situation. Another tumbling pass here. A layout step out combination pass to close her routine. Not the opening routine they were hoping for. Take a look at this front one and a half. Beautiful pop into that layout step out six. That landing lunges count as sticks on the floor. Let's not get confused there. They can land either with their feet glued tightly together in a traditional stick, or they can take the lunge without a deduction.
Well done, Lexi. As you see the score for Jack, the 9-8. There's that candlestick for Dildy, who's got a career high of 9-8. Dildy, a freshman from Virginia Beach, Virginia, part of the International VLA.
Kick over right into a back handspring. That'll count as her flight series. Nice mix of forward and backwards. Excellent cat leap into a switch side. An inside turn. We don't see a whole bunch of those. It's incredibly difficult, but fulfilling that turn requirement nonetheless. The dismount. Cartwheel, gainer full, plants the feet. Excellent beam routine. I didn't see a single bobble, Dean.
She was focused and serious. You finally saw the smile after the dismount.
Beautiful gainer. Her feet were glued together in the air. Clean twist. Sticks the landing. Okay. You missed it. There it is.
Wear the crown
for the Bean Queens.
So Maddie Johnston is gonna slip in and replace Alina Verova. Johnston has not performed on the floor this season. However, she does have a career high of 9-8. So kind of a late addition and needs to be ready. Let's see what she can do.
Why those exhibition routines are so important. Gives the athletes a chance to be prepared for these moments when you're called into the lineup seemingly at the last minute. Opens with a double pipe. Very high in the air. Looks like she did take a little bobble, steps out of that landing. Chest nice and high on that landing. Mm-hmm. leaps and jumps are just as important in floor routines as the tumbling. The judges want to see a full extension from toe to toe. One and a half. Looks like it was supposed to be a front layout, but turns into a front tuck. Not quite the ending we wanted. Looks like she had a good one and a half and just buckles in her knees just a little bit, but stays on her feet to a clean landing. You got to be in the perfect position coming out of that one and a half to be able to do the front layout, and it looks like she just wasn't quite there, but makes a game time decision and pulls out a clean front tuck.
Rachel Riley, next to go on the beam, has a career high of 9.75. Still waiting on Dildy's score. That'll give me time to tell you that Rutgers actually enters this matchup against Penn State having improved its team total in every meet this season. And that includes a 195.55 last week against Brett Nelligan's Maryland Terrapins. So that's a positive. Every meet, their score has got higher and higher as the Scarlet Knights grow together this year under Umi Celine Beasley.
It's exactly what you want the scores to do. Early in the season, it's entirely possible that you're going to see some uncharacteristic mistakes from a lot of your athletes, and bigger mistakes, possibly. But you want to see your athletes get better, the routines get better. So naturally, you would hope that the scores do as well.
I look like my calculus notes in college right there.
The hieroglyphics of the judges write in their own funky hand. You know, I think doctors have their own handwriting too, right?
Of course. So Riley has to patiently wait. Sophomore from Canada.
She's only a sophomore, so she hasn't had a few seasons under her belt to get used to having to sit and wait in these judges' conference situations. So it puts a little added pressure going into this beam routine. Let's see how she handles it.
Rutgers was solid on the beam last year, finishing 23rd. Of course, they were led by Hannah Joyner, who's now part of the coaching staff. You see Manifold with the 9.8 still waiting to get that final number for Dildy.
But a beautiful handspring layout to open up this routine. She seems unfazed. Side aerial, stick. Her rhythm is there. She looks focused and in control.
By the way, that 9.8 for Manifold is a season high.
Great extension in her legs on the jump series. See a glimpse of a smile as she looks at the judges. The most confident athletes tend to look at the judges. One and a half dismount. Fights for the stick. Doesn't quite hold it. But you want to see the fight. That was an excellent beam routine. Another look at this back handspring. Beautiful set. Opens up. Just a little toe heavy there. Turns and salutes the judges. That new rule of having to wait and hold your sticks is to try to prevent those types of landings that we used to call the college sticks of land and salute. Because as soon as you salute the judges, they can't deduct anymore, but they want to see you hold and control the landing.
Here's Ava Piedrahita. Ready to roll. Just a sophomore, but big time talent. This is rave music. They actually call her Rava now because she loves music festivals and rave music, just like me.
Well, here's your chance, Dean. We'll put you out there in that leotard next. Huge pull in, sticks the landing. clear over her teammates' heads. Those e-tumbling passes, Coach Brown said we're going to see quite a few of them. They're incredibly hard. It's the highest level of difficulty that you can do. This is rave music, that's for sure. Switch half with a full extension.
Get it, Rave and Ava?
Rava. She might have coined herself a new name for these broadcasts. Front tuck step out through to double back. Excellent landing. I'm smiling, she's smiling, Dean's smiling. Front through, right into that double back, huge set, and just pops it right onto the ground. Beautiful landings, incredible execution. It's what we expect to see from this athlete.
Yeah, we go from one superstar to another one. Emily Lease, ready to go. She has a career high on the beam of a 985.
She's very consistent on this event. And they rely on her to hit these routines week in and week out. Into a back handspring. She did have a slight bobble, which could have caused the connection to be broken. It's incredibly important that they keep their arms moving going into the back handspring. Good connection in that jump series. Going into this dismount. Punch front full, sticks the landing. Very clean routine for Emily. Gets a hug from coach. Another look at this dismount. Great set, good tuck position, opens up, plants the feet, and holds it for that clean stick.
So Monty Herring, if you see Ava with that 9.875, Monty Herring with a 9.925 career high, a season high that she got in the last meet of a 9.875. Monty, ready to roll on the floor for Penn State.
This is my kind of floor music. First tumbling pass. Huge Arabian double front. Very aware of her surroundings. Keeps her feet in bounds. Looks like she's having fun out there. Team has a lot of surprising elements in it.
Fun routine.
I'm having fun. Can't imagine how she feels. Huge 1.5 front layout. Very clean landings. say she feels pretty good after that performance. Clean tumbling, great landings, dynamic leaps. Another look here at this huge Arabian double front. Clean lunge, stays right in bounds. 1.5 front layout, huge front layout, and controls the landing. Incredible floor routine for the Nittany Lions.
Yeah, really fun routine indeed. Aired with a career high of 9.85. Again, the only all-arounder for Rutgers. Still trying to figure out the score of Emily Lease, who went fourth for Rutgers, and Umi Celine Beasley.
We expected this a little bit looking back at Emily's routine. She had that kickover followed right by the back handspring. She did possibly break connection. It's very difficult going from forwards to backwards. Your chest has to be in the perfect position and your arms have to continue moving. And with a wobble, it's entirely possible that she did break the connection, which means that she loses the requirement of having a flight series. So it's debatable what they'll do with the score, if they give her the connection and take the deduction for the wobble, or if they don't give her the connection and then it's taken off of her start value, which means she's lacking an integral connection. That's a requirement for a Beamer team.
There's Umi Celine Beasley, married to former West Virginia football All-American and NFL veteran Aaron Beasley. They've got three daughters. Amira is already running track in college. Dalia is going to run at Rutgers next year. She's a senior in high school. And apparently Layla is a potential future soccer star, where Mike O'Neill's done an amazing job with the Rutgers women's soccer team. All three of their daughters pretty talented.
You know, running was never my strong suit, so those sports were not meant for me. That's how I ended up in gymnastics. But for them to be amazing at those sports, it's quite impressive to me, Dean.
Well, pretty good combo, right? A gymnast who's flying tens on the bars and a dad who's playing in the NFL.
Very difficult mount. It's unique nonetheless. You have to give it to this Rutgers team. They're doing unique gymnastics, not just on beam, but on every event. You're not going to get the cookie cutter same routines. You're going to see their personalities and individuality in all of the routines.
Look at the white hot focus from Aired.
Handspring layout, step out with exquisite extension through her feet, all the way from her arms. Looks like that should have been a connection from that first switch leap into the switch half. Full again with the unique gymnastics, another blind landing, and she sticks it. Another look at it here. So clean and beautiful, and just finds the floor. Glues the feet. Excellent.
There's the twinkle. She's all business though up on that beam. I mean, all business.
Looks calm and in control.
Leah McElligott, see if she can match those back-to-back 9.875s.
She has beautiful lines and extension in her legs. Double pike to open the routine, but looks a little soft in her knees and does take a step forward. While all that lunge is allowed. You do have to step backwards.
Her floor coach, Rachel Innes, said that Aaliyah dances full out every day and is very confident in each and every one of her movements. I feel like you're seeing that.
Yeah, she's giving it her all. That endurance is important in this last selling pass. 1.5 front layout, very clean landing, lunges forward, which is what we want to see. Ends with a double back, very squatty in her legs, and does unfortunately step out of bounds, which will be a deduction and will come off her final score. But overall, a clean routine in the air for those tumbling passes. Just needs to focus on some of those landings. Another look at this double back. She's very high up in the air. It looks like she's pulling her legs maybe just a little too much and ends up taking a few steps out of that double back and out.
Last to go on the beam for Rutgers, as you see Gallagher getting a conversation there with Sarah Brown. They're still waiting on a score for Aird. This will be Celine Beasley. When they do get the score for Aird, it'll be Stephanie Zanella, who was part of that celebrated beam team a year ago. That was really good. That was one of the highlights for Rutgers on the beam.
They're typically very strong on this event, again, with a high level of difficulty. The execution is where they look to improve. They have a few key athletes that really lead the team year in and year out. They just got to put it all together.
Zanella was the anchor last year, and she had a 9.925 career high. Senior from New Jersey, as you see Stephanie ready to go, still waiting on Aird's score.
A lot of these athletes are being forced to wait today. Another unique mount. Beautiful Sassone up onto the beam. Nice display of artistry and technique. Split jump into a split ring jump. Incredibly difficult because you actually lose sight of the beam. You have to tilt your head all the way back. Triple series, handspring, layout, step out, sticks it, not a bobble in sight. Those full turns are a requirement. Don't think many athletes would do them if they weren't. Side aerial, top 1.5 to a step dismount. What an excellent routine for the Scarlet Knights. Picking up the momentum. Take another look at this triple series. Extension, height to a stick. Pulls those arms straight down. This dismount also beautiful. Clicks those heels together in a perfect stick. That should be a huge score for Rutgers.
Wonderful job.
I like that they're just putting the crown over top of their bones.
Fits perfectly. Isabella Salcedo with a career high of 9.95, season high 9.9, her last meet 9.675. She's already tied her career high on the vault today. Let's see what she can do on the floor. Isabella Salcedo.
It's been such a pleasure the last two seasons watching her compete. Huge front double tuck. You don't see a whole bunch of those. And she does it sixth of landing. I've been waiting for this routine all day, Dave.
Yeah, she's fun.
Excellent leaps.
It's a swing jazz mixture. It fits her personality pretty well.
Just transport you back to a different time.
Yeah.
I love when the routines tell a story. You can feel the energy.
I think the crowd does too.
Makes it more fun for the people at home too, not just the people in the stands. Your floor music's really personal. Front layout, front pull, front pike. Three elements there. Points at the judges like, I know you just saw me do that. Excellent routine for the Nittany Lions. Both her and coach should be proud of that. Take another look at this front layout, front full, front pike. Ending with a smile.
You said it earlier, Lexi. The good ones know where the camera is, particularly on the floor.
They know where the camera is. They know where the judges are. And they're not afraid to look at them. Shows an extra element of confidence.
Mattis Raines. This is the second time she's been featured in the exhibition. This freshman from Atlanta, Georgia. She looks like she's going to have a bright future. Really long lines, long legs.
It's beautiful. Can't spring layout, step out, can't quite hold on to it there and does unfortunately fall. Cat leap into a front aerial. She does break the connection in the cat leap, so she won't get the connection bonus. It's hard to recover after a fall on beam, especially earlier in your routine. Again, another split ring jump. Can't emphasize enough how difficult it is to lose sight of the beam. She's still showing quite a lot of confidence on this event, despite having a few missteps. And sticks the landing for that gainer full. It's hard to stick the landing at the end of a routine when you're feeling a little shaky when you recover from a fall. So a job well done. Take another look at this dismount. Great gainer full, good height. Good chest placement. And that's why she stuck it.
So the freshman with a chance to work the beam. Exhibition style. Ashley Mall for Penn State, also a freshman. She's from Spring, Texas, part of the Texas Connections Academy and World Champion Center. Again, this score will not count, but a good opportunity for the rookie for Penn State.
Opens with a double pike to a very clean landing. Great display of flexibility. She has beautiful artistry. Judges want to see a good balance of artistry, dynamics in your tumbling, and clean leaps and jumps. what makes up for a good floor routine. And of course, showing off your personality doesn't hurt either. But recovers nicely in that lunge. Great routine for the exhibition spot. She should feel very proud and confident after that routine.
Good opportunity for her as we've gone three out of four rotations complete at the rack. Home to the Rutgers Scarlet Knights, their visitors from Penn State looking on. Updated numbers after three. It is tight. Penn State at 146.85. Rutgers hanging in at 146.55. It's going to come down to the wire just the way you want it on the Big Ten Network, Penn State and Rutgers. A new career high for Miss Riley on the bead for Penn State. For Rutgers, rather, has put the Scarlet Knights back in it. Fourth rotation, we return. Penn State women's gymnastics, Penn State women's hoops. We have gone through three rotations and Penn State at 146.85, Rutgers at 146.55. Take a look at what Penn State did on the floor. A couple 9.875s. Salcedo with a 9.85.
This is pretty true scoring, in my opinion. We saw some great floor routines from Penn State, but we did see a couple little bobbles and squatty knees in landings. But again, as we spoke before, it gives the lineup a place to grow. It's still early in the season, so they'll look to improve upon those landings out of the tumbling passes moving forward.
And here's Rutgers scores on the beam. Stephanie Zanella with a 9.825, but a big score coming from Riley, a new career high for Rachel Riley.
It was a beautifully done beam routine. She showed the execution and a high level of execution at that. They did drop a 9.5 from Emily Lease, which is uncharacteristic from her, but still had to count a 9.5. They're going to want to clean up some of the connection errors that they had going from either some leaps and jumps and the flight series. Those are requirements, and it will unfortunately dock your score quite a bit.
Take a look at the lineup for the floor. Zanella, Aird, Webster, Dildy, Wood, and Lease. And you got three seniors in there. You got a junior. You're really tight. I feel like it's a great opportunity for Rutgers to get their first Big Ten win of the season.
They're looking to capitalize on the floor exercises. It's typically a very high-scoring event for most teams, especially Big Ten teams, because they have a high level of difficulty and execution. And that's what we're going to see from Rutgers today, or at least hope to see. And this floor lineup is a veteran floor lineup, so hopefully we'll get to see that. Taking a look at beam for Penn State, again, we have some sophomores, a freshman in Kalia McGillicutt, but ending with Maddie Johnston as a senior. We're going to see a lot of interesting beam routines, but Coach Brown said that they're putting up clean gymnastics, clean, safe gymnastics that's going to warrant good scores if they execute the way that she knows that they can.
Lexi, you've been around long enough to know that McGilligan does not look like your everyday freshman. I mean,
no.
She looks like she is ready to go.
Some freshmen come in and they need a bit of transition time. And let me tell you, preseason is not enough for them to transition. And sometimes it takes a year or two for them to really hone in and get their sea legs or gymnastics legs, if you will. But she's come in and just hit the ground running. She's prepared for competition. She looks calm. She looks in control. And it looks like she's been doing this for years, which is very difficult for freshmen. She's handling the pressure very well.
As always, great job by our Big Ten Network crew. Jim Ressler, Jeff Clark, and the gang. Deep breaths, big huddle, and some words from Sarah Brown. Sarah, I just thought it was hilarious how she admitted how fast she talks and how loud she talks. And then apparently Elijah and Isaiah, her two little boys, basically, I guess they talk just as fast as what she was breaking down.
She's raising some strong little boys. She said herself she runs a tight ship.
All right, final rotation ready. This is tight.
Only a few tenths separate these teams. The leadoff position's a hard place to be in on beam. You're setting the tone. Ending on beam is incredibly difficult for any team. My dad, who was my coach, always makes a joke that she who hits beam wins. So it's going to come down to the team that puts on a better beam show.
Ava Piedrahita will lead off for Coach Brown and Penn State. She comes in with a career high of 9.875, season high 9.85 last week, last meet 9.8.
To that back handspring layout, step out, perfect landing. She looks confident. We've seen her all over the lineups tonight. Beautiful side aerial. It's really showing her depth in this team. Recovering after a slight bobble after that switch half. Just the dismount. Round off 1.5, slight hop forward. Excellent leadoff for the Nittany Lions. Coach Brown should be proud of that routine. Good pop off of that round off. Clean twist. Just wanted to plant those heels a little tighter into the ground. But she has a hop forward.
She does routinely stick that, so she won't love that hop.
She won't love the hop, but you know what? A hop forward is better than a hop backwards. It's a fine line going for those hops.
So here's Stephanie Zanella with a career high of 9.85. Big time leadoff for Rutgers.
Huge double back to open up this routine. Again, those lunges are important. Your feet don't want to move, especially the front foot. It shouldn't slide backwards. Front layout, front full.
Just a Again, little skip, right?
Yes. You want the feet to be planted. Those little feet movements can be anywhere from a half a tenth to a tenth off your score.
All right, Lexi, Rutgers has to know they've got a great chance to win this. Does that amp up the pressure?
Of course it does. But you know what? These athletes are trained to handle the pressure, and they want to do good gymnastics and control what they can control, which are those landings. So unfortunately, she did take a hop there, and it was a hop forward. That's why those lunges are so important, because your feet can pop to a lunge instead of taking a hop. But a great leadoff nonetheless for the Scarlet Knights. It's going to come down to details for both of these lineups.
high fives for Zanella. As up next will be Haley Gibble, sophomore from Pennsylvania. Gibble with career high, season high, and last meet high of 9-9. A 9-9 would go a long way in helping Penn State secure a road victory.
She has some beautiful eye makeup.
Solid.
Let's hope this Beamer teen's as beautiful as those eyes she has. Step out, plants the feet, doesn't move.
It's a good start.
Front aerial split jump. She was a little off, but saved it. Went right into the split jump anyways and didn't lose the deduction for the connection.
So did not lose anything on that wobble?
They might take a 10 for the wobble, but they'll give her the connection, which is important. It won't mean that the judges are going to take off at the end of her routine for losing a required connection between two skips. One and a half dismount to a stick. That is a veteran competitor. She knew what she was doing up there, and that's why she's gotten 9-9s in the past. Another look at this flight series. Back handspring, layout, step out, holds it. Cartwheel, one and a half. Arms come right in front, feet are glued. Incredible. Her team's excited. That's what they need.
I would say that performance matches the eyewear.
Right.
That was good.
I should have her do my makeup. I don't know if I can pull off that electric blue.
Here's Aird. You see Zanella with the 9.85. Aird with a career high 9.9 on the floor.
Huge double pike. Does have that slide lunge that we talked about that we don't really want to see. We want to see the feet glued in the lunge, and she does slide that front foot backwards.
The all-arounder, every single rotation, the expression does not change for Air.
It's her game face. Front layout, front pull, much better landing. Two or three tumbling passes. They can really do as many as they want, but typically we'll see two or three. Ending with a double tuck, perfect landing. Ending with a beautiful display of flexibility and a smile from coach for the all-arounder wrapping up her night.
Takes a little time. So finally get there. Kalia McGilligan, the freshman that we have talked quite a bit about. Superstar from New York, part of the Infinity Elite Gymnastics Program. 9.825 career high in her rookie campaign.
Back handspring. Layout, step out, the triple series, that's incredibly difficult. Sticks it cold. Hitting the 180 and possibly extending it even higher. on those leaves. She looks focused, Dean.
Yeah, exquisite. Little grin to the judges.
Just a small hop on the dismount. I thought she had it there, Dean. That was an incredible beam routine.
It's interesting when you get down to this stage, that little hop could be the difference.
It is for sure. Again, controlling what they can control, and those dismounts could be a tenth or two that either closes the lead or gives the lead away.
Here's Harmony Webster, the sophomore from Georgia Mill Creek High School, with a career high of 985. They throw in a little kind of marching band music in there.
Shows a little bit of school spirit. Controls that landing, doesn't let the feet move. Huge double tuck to end. Very clean landing. That was a fun routine.
Harmony Webster, as we move over to Imani Herring. McElligott with a new career high, 9.875. Herring has a career high of 9.925. Season high of 9.85 that she had in her last meet.
She opened with that kickover back handspring with a beautiful connection between the two. Super hard side summy. You see the beam the whole way through and then turn at the last second. Incredibly difficult. The sideways landing she's got down pat. Just the dismount. Tuck front full. Almost had the stick, but just a slight hop forward. These are very clean beam routines from the Nittany Lions. Good punch, nice body position in the air, and just the hop forward.
Gabriel Dildy, 9.8 career high. We've had three straight 9.85s for Rutgers. Dildy, if she got a 9.85, would be a new career high.
I think she has it in her.
Freshman from Virginia Beach, Virginia, part of the International VLA.
Opening up with a front tuck, step out through to double back. I love the combination passes. Makes me want to dance along with her.
I was already dancing.
Well, it's a good thing they're on camera and not us. Small lunge, but her feet don't move. Don't see many Shushanovas anymore. But that was a great way to end her routine. I don't know, Dean, do you think she can top her career high?
Solid performance. She was into it.
I think so, too. This front through to double back was so well done. She was very aware of her surroundings and keeps that back foot right in bounds inside the tape.
I feel some suspense building here. This is going to be tight.
I'm on the edge of my seat.
Yeah. Isabel Salcedo with a 9.95 career high on the beam. This young woman is a performer.
I love watching her compete beam. Handspring layout step out for the flight series. You can see her talking to herself through the routine. It's such a show of confidence. Standing punch front, stuck. No lunge, no bobble. It's even so hard to do that on the floor, and she does it on the beam. And sticks it cold every time.
She's fun to watch. She uses her words up there. I know that everybody does different things at the beam, but you can hear her talking to herself.
Just a small bobble on those jumps. Front full stop. Recovers nicely after that uncharacteristic bobble. Front tuck. Her arms go right out and up.
What a great shot right there. That was awesome.
Wow. Big hug from Coach.
Coming up next, Penn State at Northwestern women's basketball right here on the Big Ten Network. The Nittany Lions women's gymnastics team trying to pull it out on the road at Rutgers. It's not going to be easy, though, as Emily Wood with a career high of 9.925. The senior from Kingsland, Georgia, Camden County High School.
They're going to need a big score from her on this event. Wow, super impressive. Front 1.5 into a very high flying layout step out. Seeing the smiles on the athletes' faces as they're competing. Good execution of jumps. Score music throughout this lineup so far. Ending with a front double full. Wow, so hard. That's an E tumbling pass. So hard and done so well. Her team greets her out on the floor. This front 1.5, look at how high up in the air she is. And you see her chest kind of pop up there before she even hits the ground. Beautiful lunge. Wow.
Maddie Johnston, as you see right now, they're sitting on a 49-1. All solid scores. Maddie Johnston does have a career high of 9.9, a season high of 9.875. Penn State would love a score right around there.
it's going to come down to the details, Dean. Like that stuck backhand spring layout step out.
That was clean, no?
Very clean. Straight legs, pointed toes. Split jump, ring jump. Very difficult combination. Again, those ring jumps lose sight of the balance beam. Where was that side aerial? You're staring at the beam the entire time. Both have very interesting parts to them and can be very hard to execute well. She hasn't bobbled yet, Dean.
Nope, she's coming off a 9.775, so needs to put that in the rearview mirror.
I don't even think she's thinking about it right now. One and a half, just the hop forward. Excellent routine in the anchor spot. That came in clutch.
So it is tight. We are starting to tabulate numbers to figure out what Emily Leese might need. She has a career high of 9.925. We're still waiting on the score for Emily Wood as the two Emilys go 5 and 6 for Umi, Celine, Beasley, and Rutgers. Emily Leese, the senior from Lancaster, PA. Here we go. This could be for the win.
Let's see if she can pull it out here. Opening with a big full in, just a small hop forward into that lunge. Another Shushinova. I spoke too soon. Listen, I could put Rutgers floor music on a playlist. This is fun. Front tuck step out into a double back, perfect landing. That's why she's the anchor. Incredible floor routine. Giving herself a round of applause. It's a vote of confidence.
Still waiting for the final tabulations. It is indeed going to be tight. Penn State and Rutgers. Because we were still waiting for the Emily Wood score, we did not know exactly what Emily Leese, who you see right there on your Big Ten Network screen, needed. Still see on the bottom right-hand corner how tight it was through three rotations.
Athletes did a lot of gymnastics today, a lot of great gymnastics. What I think is interesting for this point in the season is they have room to improve. It's just the end of January, and it's early in the season before championship season comes around. They have a lot more gymnastics to do, and we'll hopefully see them improve on some of those landings and the details that we talked about being so important.
9.875 for Leese. Remember, Stephanie Zanella opened up with a career high of 9.85, which got you starting to think that maybe Rutgers had a chance. The way Penn State is fired up over there, perhaps they got it done. Pure speculation now as they're still. And Penn State had enough. 196.075. Rutgers, oh so close, but they'll fall with a 195.85. That's going to wrap it up from Rutgers, where the final score again is Penn State with a slim lead over Rutgers. Coming up next, it's women's basketball, Penn State and Northwestern with Mike Hall and Shimmy Gray Miller. For the former Buckeye Lexi Madden, I'm Dean Linke. Good night from Piscataway.